Hello everyone, today my Samuel against the 10 premier members of the Chess24. So I think we can start now. Please make the moves. Play Scandinavian. E4 here. I'm going to play London. Bishop F4, Queen D8. Other line is Queen D5 or Queen D6. Knight F6, compare Knight F3. Dodge. Bishop G4, if I play H3, I take on F3, E6. Bishop E3, E6, and castle long. And it's one possible line. Castle long. Play C6 and expect it. Here instead of E3, I can also go Knight E2 with idea G3, Bishop G2. After Knight E2, maybe he'll continue with Queen D5. Stop my plan. Try to castle long. Yeah, you see now if I castle. You may play Bishop B4. After Knight E4, he takes, Queen takes, maybe he'll play Queen D5. Now instead of Queen D5, if I play Queen G4, he take on A2, C3. Bishop F8. So maybe it's more accurate to play bishop d3 first. Now to bishop b4, I make castle short. D4 being played. Then play E4 and Sicilian. Knight d7 play now. I'm going to castle long. After bishop b4, I can play knight e2. Knight d5, rook king b1, knight e3, fe, and queen e7, rook f1, I don't know what to try. c6. Oh, it's the same game. Bishop f4. He played bishop before. I need to choose between 94 and 92. 94, he takes. I take the queen, knight f6. If I play queen h4, knight d5. So maybe 92 here. Castle. With a reversed Grünfeld, I play e6, so the percent transport to main line of Catalan. To take. It takes. Okay. 9 second, 5. Fishing cough. I think he will take on e3. And I can open F line and get some attacking tries. Take the d4, this is not that common. The most common move is d takes c4. Now I can take bishop c5, choose between knight b3 and knight c6. e6 played, c3 move. I play c4 after bishop f4, this is a little bit surprising. Play e6. h3, it's a mean move in this position. Takes on d4, and normally white takes back with the e pawn. Since the bishop inside of the pawn chain, so it might be a little bit passive. And knight h3. If you play bishop d6, I'm going to a knight e5. F3. Queen f6. It's going to exchange the queen. Of course, I'm not going to allow it. Queen g3. I don't know what happens in these four games. Yeah, bishop c5 played. And now, bishop, if knight b3, bishop b6, knight c3. He castled a bishop g5 here, and d takes c4, knight d2, knight e5, knight e4. Hello. Yes. Sure. Okay. Only 5 games, so I can just cancel it. Okay, G6. Now he's going to take my knight. Now if I play bishop b5, he may answer queen c7. No, it's not. I didn't see a follow-up after queen c7, so maybe I'll develop another knight to f3. Knight c2. Think the main line here is castle. Castle long. Did he just lost the pawn on f3, f7? Since I can rook f1. Oh, this rook, queen e7, queen g7, rook g8, queen f7. Rook g2, I take on e7 and then knight f4, knight e6. Play very energetically the h4 to prevent bishop g5, and maybe he's going to play g3 later with bishop h3, king f1, king g2, this idea. A5, I think, should be played. Had to castle. But now, yeah, can I take on f7? I think it's a free pawn. Oh, played knight f3. I'm going to, I didn't go in, I'm not going to take on d5 since after that his bishop may become active. g3 played. I need to find a plan for Black. Bishop e6 had to be played. Thanks. Knight d3, he's going to play e5. Maybe I have to play knight g4, but then he's still going to play e5. I take, take the pawn. Maybe I play h3. Knight, at least my knight better place on g4 and d3. We take on c4. Now I can exchange the queen. takes, he takes the bishop and knight d2. Knight e5. Knight d4, he takes, take the knight, make castle, bishop f4. Maybe bishop c7, rook c1, bishop d7, knight c5. It seems slightly better. With knight d2 immediately, maybe play knight e5. But it's not good. I have to take queen. And b4. Now if I take on g7, we play bishop d6. Okay, I can go knight e4, knight f4. Okay, knight d2. Knight g7, he's going to play h5. And also knight f5. So I have to play knight h6, I think. Prevent idea. Bishop three played. Not sure how to continue here. Maybe just take the knight and play knight b8. Now if f4, bishop b6, king h1, knight g4, knight c4, knight f2. I take take e3, bishop e1. What about knight b5? He castles knight d6. Have many possible moves. Another one, knight e4. Knight e7. This is interesting. We're going to play knight f5 or e5 at some point. So I'm going to stop the idea completely, but I'm not very sure about this move. Knight f4. Maybe he's going to play queen d2 and rook d1 and knight b3. But just the rook. Oh. And that takes on e4, he may castle, then bishop f4. Takes on d5. I have to get back. If I play knight d4, I'm worried about knight d4 take and queen d3. No, then my bishop will be very, very bad. Also, his bishop control important c8 square where I cannot control the c-file. B2. this position. Maybe he castle knight a6, knight e3, knight c5, or queen f3. Knight e4 or b6. Knight c6. Now you're going to play e5 and bishop e6. After rook c1, if we play e5, bishop e3, bishop e6, and I will go knight c5. Rook c1 play. Maybe after knight c5, you're going to take on c5. If I take knight c4, you're going to castle long with queen b6. But still he had to look at f8, then castle. Queen d2. going to Castle Long. Maybe the best move for him is to e7. This is very strong. But bishop e6, I think it's a mistake. And after bishop b6, take on e6 and b6, then c4. How can I get the D5 break? Yeah. I think it's the time for D5. It takes. Can take on c2 and take on d5. 98. Going to spend my night. And then castle shots. So I'm going to prevent it that. Mate in two. He had to get back. And now I was much better. Instead, he should have played bishop e7. Oh. Queen a4. With this move, he didn't drop. He just. Oh, he has the idea bishop f4. Bishop e7 now. I can take on b7 here. You're going to play e5. Knight f5 here. We play bishop f8, he may go bishop f4. And 97. Play d5, I'm going to play knight d4 afterwards. I play knight e4, he take and knight d4. Knight c5, take on e6, I take and queen takes. Looks good for black. Now if e5. I take on e5, he takes, and knight g5. And bishop c5. Bishop g5. It didn't look so good. complicated idea. Still, I cannot play queen d7 since you're going to play knight h6. I'd like to play g5, but I didn't like bishop f4, then knight f5. Maybe I have to take the knight, then go g5. But after e5, the position looks drawish. I take on f6, he takes, take on e5, take, knight takes, rook takes, I takes, queen takes, maybe c4, and d4, take, he takes. You're going to play for a win. Take on e3 and a6. If we take on f7, I take bishop e6 and I have rook a7. So he's going to play rook d7 and after queen b6, he plays queen f2. I still have rook a7. I can't find a move. Knight d1. I think if you go d5, let me take and bishop d5. This looks very dangerous. Now I can play bishop c7, prepare bishop d6 instead of take a5. Maybe rook h8, control file. Queen f2, but turn rook a7. Now I don't think he had any advantage left. Queen f7. And I'm going to play f4. I don't have enough time in this game. Fortunately, the position is very, very good for me. And rook a2. No, he cannot play knight d3 since the c5 pawn will be hanging. F5. Now if g5, then my bishop will be very very bad after knight h5. I'm going to take and g5, h6, knight f3, take rook. I cannot play rook h8. After g5, he may go queen c7. Knight c6. He's going to play knight queen h4. We want to pawn knight c4. Now he found Queen C7. Now it's a present for Black. This was the most complex game.93, I missed this move. Take rook c6. Oh, this is lost. I totally missed rook c4. But anyway, my position is worse. he can simply play rook b4. If I take on f5, take on f6, then take on b7. Now if he plays h6, I'm going to go play h5. If he play h6, I may take on h6, then knight g5. And this should be positionally winning for black. I can play f5, we take, I take with rook. I think queen cannot. Cannot protect the two pawns in the same time. And before. Now I can take on h6, rook h8, knight g5, bishop f4, queen to g2, rook h6. Take on e6. Is there any miracle? After bishop h4, I take with d3. Just take with bishop. I have to resign. After Queen G2, he may play Rook D, Rook E8. He didn't see Bishop H4. Which if I take on G3, he can play Rook G4. I have Rook F2. To Rook E8. I have Knight F7. So I can take with the King and Queen 2 take and Knight D7, Knight B2. 97. If you play King E2, Knight D2, and then Knight C4, we go King F3, Knight B2, Bishop D1, Knight Bishop F1, Knight D1, and Knight C3, B2. But after h4, he lost his bishop. After Bishop F1, Knight D1, Bishop D3, King G5, King F3, Knight C3. If I play Queen C3, he has Queen C1. castles, kings, and queens. And then play king of eight, king seven. And the only move to keep the pawn is queen c1. And I believe it looked, became Jewish. Here he blundered bishop g7. I was back in the game. Your lines. And I'm certain rook g7, rook d7, rook g8, rook d8 taken, bishop d7. I found a good move. Which I have to take. It's a dream position for black. This is the most straightforward win. Straightforward maze. Let's draw. Maybe a 6. It's not easy to win. It's meant to be the last game. The defense setup is very solid. Queen e6, I'm going to play queen b4. I'm not going to exchange queens. Thank you. King is more dangerous than mine. Checks first. I'm not going to play King e2 since after Queen e6. I have to play c4 if I don't want to exchange queen. Suddenly, position looks very dangerous since I'm going to play rook h8, king a7, queen c5, queen b6, and rook a8. Now I have a deadly straight rook h8. Maybe his only move was queen f6. And queen h6 is the only move. A5, you may play rook d7 or rook h7. After rook h7, I can play queen d8 and rook f6. After rook d7, So maybe I can check on d8 first, then a5. If rook c7, I can go rook f6. If rook h7, also rook f6. Seems this is a winning idea. Rook c7, rook f6, he has queen c1, knight2, queen c2. It's a bit annoying. So after rook c7, maybe I'll play rook e1 with idea rook e8. After rook e1, since his queen had to protect the bishop on d6, cannot play queen a5. Since I can take on d6, queen a5, b1, queen a5, king c1, or rook e4. So rook e1 here, the winning move. Queen d2. Rook h1 here. Yes, rook h1, but he has queen f8. Seems not that easy. Rook f6, queen c1, queen a2. And bishop a3, queen a1, d1, queen b4. Now if queen c2, I can take on d6 with queen. After queen a4, queen a3, remove. Black bishop a3 played. Take with queen. And after rook c6, play king a2. Now, king b4. I have mate in 2, rook a6 and queen a8. If we play queen e2, I can simply take on a6, take on a6 with queen, and I play queen c7. When no check, and he didn't have stalemate without this pawn. He has stalemate after, for example, rook c4, king takes, and queen b3. With this pawn on the board, there's no stalemate for him. King c5 is also possible. Here is more clear since he cannot sacrifice his pawn at any point. h4 is a very safe square for my king. Okay. Which game? Oh, okay. Yes. Okay. Yeah. But this one, I must admit that. He's talking to you before the game, right? Actually, during this game, I didn't play well in the opening, and he get a big advantage after opening. I think he played very well.
Hello, Mr. Din Liren.
Hello,
Hello.
Mr.
Thank you very
Sir.
much for the game. It has been a big pleasure. Thanks a lot. It has been awesome.
Yes, I think you play very well until some point. You're clearly pushing for the win since you declined the draw offer. And the position isn't very good for you, I think.
Probably, I think knight c4, it was simply possible instead of knight g4 again. That's
But after knight c4, I can take on c6 and play queen c7.
yeah.
I don't have a square for the knight.
So I have a very important question for you, if you let
So
me.
I think after bishop g7, you can play h5 instead of knight e3.
I have Mr. Diliren, excuse me. I have a very, very important question that because I'm streaming at the same time in my Twitch channel. People would like to know if in case I repeat with knight g4, knight e3, knight g4, knight e3, you were going to accept the draw.
Yes.
Or did you feel like to play that? No,
No, I'm going to
to
the draw. Yeah, since my
okay.
position is worse, I think much worse actually. Yeah, since I didn't have good as understanding of this kind of structure, so my play is not so good. After I think h4. My move, not that good.
Yes.
You play very well.
When you trade on d5, it was a little surprise for me. I didn't expect it. I thought you were going to maintain your bishop on e6. If I take, you can take with the f7 pawn. It was my idea.
Yes.
So it was a surprise.
Yeah. Also, I think it's a mistake to take the knight.
Yeah, probably. Okay.
Maybe I have to play rook b8 here instead of bishop d5. If you play b3, maybe I can go queen d7.
The problem, I thought that if you some point played knight queen d7, I could trade on
Six.
f6.
Yes.
So I thought the idea that could be a problem for me was if you had time to play Queen D7 and Bishop D8, but it was
yes.
not possible because of my trade on F6.
Yes, if I can get my bishop to D8, then I am totally fine. But the problem is, in case I play Queen D7, you will always take on F6.
Yeah. And maybe your castle could have some problems if I exchange on F6. So
yeah. Maybe. Yeah, so you are better until you allow me to exchange the knight on e3.
Yeah, now you are okay probably after bishop take on e3.
Yes, yes. I'm just in time since I have rook a7.
Yeah. I didn't see rook a7. That was the problem.
Yeah.
I didn't see rook a7. So after that, everything is under control for black.
Yeah, and I have a better knight against the bad bishop. Anyway, it's a very lucky win for me. Actually, after the opening, I feel,
yeah.
feel very bad about my position. Your move rook c1 actually is very strong.
Yeah, thinking of the exchange, the sacrifice
yeah.
on c5.
Yes.
I see again not exactly the same position, but with the same idea with this structure. I knew that idea, and when playing the game, the idea came to me, and I was very happy thinking that could happen in the game.
Yeah.
Of course, you didn't let it. You didn't allow
yeah.
it.
Yeah, also, your move is very strong.
Yeah.
But I think you missed. For example, after bishop g7, after 22, bishop g7, you have h5. I think this is very strong. Now, if I take on h5, you play knight e3, and after bishop h6, you have knight f5.
The f5 square, yeah.
Yeah, you find a good square knight. That's most important.
And if you don't take on h5?
If I take on c6, then knight e3.
Okay, another way to try in that position. So interesting. Okay. So, Mr. Dilly Deng, it has been a so nice experience for me. If you want, in the next time you play a simul, and if Chess24 is agreed, I could try again if you give me the rematch for the next time.
Okay. No problem. You have white pieces. I'll repeat this line.
Yeah. Next time I play with black pieces.
Black.
For 1 second in that position, yes. For 1 second in that position, I thought I could have some source with trying to play against your knight on b2 in some variant. When you take the pawn on b2, if I. Mm-hmm. could have my bishop on e2, but
e2,
of course
yeah.
it's not possible. That was, but I don't know if there is some
yes.
way I don't think so. Maybe if I play king, no. the key
yeah,
was to
not
play
in time.
King e1, but it's not possible because here king e1, everything could work, but with your knight on b3, it's not legal.
Yeah.
So it's working for you this variation,
F5, I missed your idea, queen e2 and then rook g4.
Mm.
After queen e2, I saw it.
Yeah, it was the last try in the position. For 1 second, maybe for 5 seconds, I have thought that I was winning because I didn't see rook f2.
Yeah. At first, I thought after rook g4, my queen checked, but I saw rook 2.
No.
Strange.
There is no other try, I think. Another try for me. Yeah. That. So. Okay. Yeah, I think this is the critical moment with knight c4 even. Knight c4 instead of or the h5 you mentioned.
Yes.
But knight c4, it's also very nice, I think. I have been looking with Stockfish after the game. A rook c4, it's also very, instead of knight g4, it's very interesting because I don't know if you have something better than accepting the exchange.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I don't know if you understand me. Knight c4 instead of knight g4, maybe it could work. Yeah, here knight c4, it was a good try for white in this position.
Yes, maybe after knight c6, you take queen c7, bishop d7.
Yeah.
And then rook d1.
Yeah.
Idea.
I don't know if black has something better than try to give back the exchange some point, but it doesn't look easy.
Yeah.
Okay, Mr. Dilliren, thank you very much. This has been a great moment for me, for my sons, and for my from the sum of my sums in the future. Thank you very much. Really, thank you very
thank
much.
You.
It has been a big honor, a great pleasure. Nice to meet you. Nice to play with you. And thanks a lot. Also, of course, to you. Thanks to you. And thanks a lot to Chess24 for this nice moment.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Yes. Yeah, okay. That's for today and also for this month's activity. See you next month.